I'm about to share with you a dream every single Muslim should know of. A dream, ru'ya, which Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam had. This ru'ya, this dream is found in Sahih al-Bukhari. What's the story? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from his habit after salah, he asks the people, هَلْ أَحْدٌ مِنْكُمْ رَأَى رُؤْيَا? Any one of you saw a dream last night so I can explain, so I can describe the meaning of your dream? And Rasulullah SAW, one day, he told the Sahaba about his own dream, and that's what we want to really focus on and learn very well. He said, last night, أَتَانِي رَجُلَانِ, two people came to me in my dream and they woke me up in the dream. So I got up. So they told me, انطلق, proceed, proceed. And in this dream, there are seven scenes I want to share with you, inshallah. And we'll explain what each one is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَانْطَلَقْنَا. Then I went with these two people. Who are they? You will know, inshallah. We went and went and we saw a man lying on the ground. And the man who's lying on the ground, his head was right here, and behind his head was a man holding a rock, hajara. So this man holding the rock looks at the man lying down and he throws the rock and it smashes and crushes the guy's head. Destroys the head. Rasulullah says, فَيَتَدَحْرَجْ. That rock rolls and rolls. So the thrower of the rock runs after the rock to pick it up. By the time he picks up the rock, he returns back to the man lying on the ground. His head comes back to normal, as if nothing happened. And he does it again, he smashes the hand. The pain is fresh, continuous. So Rasulullah says in the dream, Subhanallah, ma hadani, what's these two people doing? What's going on? So the two people next to the Prophet, they say, intaliq, intaliq, proceed, proceed. Scene number two. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes a very similar position. A man lying on his back and a man standing on above his head. Does he have a rock? No. He has a hook. A hook made out of iron, hadid, steel. And what does he do? Three things. Ya'ti bi'ayni, he goes to the guy's head. Half of the side first, half of the head. He gets the hook and he pokes his eye. And he goes all the way back ila qafah, which is the back of the head. Tears his face apart. Then he goes into the same side but the nose. Now we go from the eyes to the nose. And he rips his nose all the way to the back. Then he goes to the third part, which is the mouth, and he tears it all the way to the back. Rasulullah is explaining it as detailed as I'm making it, be me Allah, accept from all of us. The Prophet says, and by the time this man goes to the other side of the face, that first side goes back to normal. And he does it with the eyes, pokes it all the way to the qafah, meaning the back of the head. Then he goes into the nostrils, the nose. He rips it all the way to the back and the mouth rips it all the way to the back. Some of you are distressed, maybe. Some of you have never heard this hadith before, maybe. Rasulullah says, Subhanallah, ma hadan. He is also terrified. He says to the people next to him in the dream, what's going on? Who are these two people? They said, intaliq, intaliq, proceed, proceed. To scene number three. What's scene number three? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, and we saw a tannur. A tannur is like an oven. An oven that is a cone shaped. Laysa lahu makhraj. And Rasulullah sallam says, ثُمَّ نَظَرْنَا. So we looked inside the oven and we saw men and women without any clothes. Nothing. Naked. Ura. The Prophet says, then the fire, shu'la minna, the fire is turned on. When the fire is turned on, the naked men and women, they try to leave the oven. And they cannot because the oven is closed. So Rasulullah asked the people next to him, man ha'ula, who are these people? They said, intaliq, intaliq, proceed, proceed. To scene number four. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in scene number four, he saw a man swimming in a river red like blood. Nahar ahmar kaddam. And as that man is swimming, there's another man standing on the shore or the bank of the river holding hijara, rocks. And when the man swimming, he comes to the edge of the river, he opens his mouth. And the one standing throws the rock inside the mouth. فَيَسْبَحْ وَيَسْبَحْ. So the guy goes back to swimming. Then he comes back to the bank, he opens his mouth, then that man standing throws another rock. And he goes back to swimming and swimming. So the Prophet says to the two people, مَنْ هَؤُلَاءِ, what's going on? They said, انطلق, انطلق, proceed, proceed. Then we go to scene number five out of seven. That scene is interesting. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and I saw one man. with such repulsive appearance. His look is something I've never seen before. Scary, freaky, repulsive. You see, like, you don't want, unbelievable. I've never seen anything like that before. So Rasulullah says, this man was kindling fire. يشعل النار ويسعى حولها. And he used to turn that fire on and he used to go around that fire. Very scary scene. So the Prophet asked the two people, من هذا? Who's this man? They said, انطلق, انطلق, proceed, proceed. So they went to the sixth scene. What's going on here? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now he saw hadiqa, a beautiful garden with so much dense vegetation. Ayy, alhamdulillah, now a positive, kullu positive, all khair inshaAllah. But the sixth scene is different than the previous five. Beautiful garden. He says, فَرَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا طَوِيلًا. I saw a man who's so tall, I can barely see his head for how tall he was. وَحَوْلَهُ, and around that tall man are so many children. I've never seen so many kids in these amounts in my life before. So I asked, what's going on, and so on. But they never tell him what's really happening. And then we go to the seventh scene, and the last one before we explain all seven inshaAllah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فانطلقنا, so we proceeded until we saw a garden that I've never seen anything like before. Not even the one before was like this one. This was special. And in it is, around it is a gate. And so we went to that gate and we opened that gate. So then the two guys told me, اطلع, go up, rise. And we rose all the way up until we found a Medina, a whole city made out of bricks of gold and silver. Medina كاملة, حجر, بناؤها من الذهب والفضة. And in it, I saw men I've never seen before. How? They looked two opposite images in the same body. One half, أجمل ما يكون, so handsome. I've never seen men more handsome than them, that half. But then their other half, أبشع ما يكون, it was so unattractive, so ugly, if you wish to say. The other half, strange. So then one of the two people that were with me told all these men, jump into that river, jump into that nahar. والنهر كان أبيض كالحليب أو كاللبن. That river was so white, and they jumped into it. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, then when they left the river, they became all beautiful. Then one of the two people next to the Prophet, they said, look. So the Prophet looked, and it was a beautiful palace in the shape of like a cloud, كالغيمة. So they said to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, هذا قصرك, هذا بيتك, this is your palace. So he said, بارك الله فيكم. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, may Allah bless you, now get me inside it. They said, لا بعد, not yet. The time will come where you will enter that place. So Rasulullah says, you made me see so many strange things today. Please explain. They said, now we will explain. The two people next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the dream were angels. They were malaika. As for the one who was lying on the ground and was being struck by a rock that crushed his head, فَهَذَا الرَّجُلُ, this man used to read the Qur'an, but he abandoned it. كان يحفظ كتاب الله ويقرأ القرآن, doing great job, but he completely ignored the Quran. It's no longer part of his life. ولا يعمل به, and no longer applies its ruling. وكان ينام عن الصلاة المكتوبة, and this person used to intentionally, doesn't care, in missing salah. يا أخي, get up, put your alarm. No, I got exams, I got this. You intentionally miss salah? The Prophet says, this man's punishment, because he intentionally ينام, used to sleep in and miss salah. May Allah not make us of that group. Ya Rasulullah, who's the other group? Group number two out of seven, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the angels explained to him, the man who was lying on the ground and there was a hook ripping their eyes, their nose, and their mouth were people. In the morning when they wake up, they would go out and start lying. Lying right and left. كذب, lying, whether about jobs, about their lives, about their feelings, about what they did, about what they will do. كذب, lie upon lie upon lie. حتى تبلغ الكذب الآفاق, until they lie that one lie that goes viral. A lie that spreads like wildfire. That's the punishment of the liars. May Allah protect us. The eye, the nose, and the mouth. What about the scene, the third one? Ya Rasulullah, about the people in the oven. The two angels says, as for the naked men and women that you saw in the oven, they are az-zunatu wa-z-zawani. May Allah protect us. They are the ones who commit that major sin of fornication and adultery. May Allah protect us, Ya Allah. May Allah protect the elders and the youngsters, the men and the women, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. That's the punishment. And subhanAllah, the punishments as you see them are similar to the sins that they committed. The clothes were off, the clothes are off. You went for that moment of 5-10 minutes and that fire gets turned on for 5-10 minutes. Allah knows best to burn them. May Allah protect us and forgive us all, Ameer Rabbi Al-Alameen. Scene number four. The man who was swimming in the river that is red like blood and rocks were being thrown in their throats and into their stomachs. فَهَذَا آكِلُ الرِّبَى. It's the one who deals with interest and so on and eats from it. May Allah make our income halal. May Allah make our spending in the halal and our income in halal both ways. Ya رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Number five. That man that you saw in which their physical features was extremely scary. The one who is igniting the fire and goes around it is Malik. Who's Malik? Khazinu Jahannam. He's the gatekeeper of Jahannam. Allahumma ajirna min adhab an-nar. Then Rasulullah ﷺ, the last two scenes. As for the very tall man, that we could not see his head for how tall he was and all the kids around him. هذا إبراهيم عليه السلام. And all these children are the children who died when they were young. ذرار المسلمين. So all you who lost a child before the age of puberty, أبشر. Good news. They are with the greatest of human beings, إبراهيم عليه السلام. And inshallah, يوم القيامة, all you who lost your son or daughter when they were young, بإذن الله. In another hadith, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم teaches us that they will be reunited with their believing mom and dad, inshallah. May Allah grant you patience and grant you the reward of that calamity you went through. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. All these kids, dharar al-Muslimin. One of the Sahaba asked Rasulullah in this hadith, said, Ya Rasulullah, wa awlad al-Mushrikeen. But what if they were the children of the Mushrikeen? He says, wa awlad al-Mushrikeen. And even the children from the Mushrikeen parents who died before the age of puberty. And they might find a difference of opinion, but we respect both, inshallah. What about the seventh and last scene? The men who were half gorgeous and half very unattractive. Rasulullah ﷺ says, these are the men, خَلَطُوا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَعَمَلًا سَيِّئًا. They are the people who do the deed and they mix the deed with good stuff and then they do the bad stuff. So they had that mix. So when we go to that river, inshallah, we are wiped from that evil. And may Allah make us all of the people of Jannah.